so much for watching. Today, we're going to be talking about the difference between a hallucination and an illusion. This is something that sometimes students struggle with. They ask me, what is the difference? Can you please help? So let's get started. Hallucination versus an illusion. Let's hit the books. First, like always, my disclaimer that this information is purely for educational purposes only and is not intended as medical advice. And I'm in school right now for family nurse practitioner, and this is how I feel right now about this semester. Yeah. Hallucination. A hallucination is the experience of perceiving objects or events that don't have an external source. That is a key word there. There's nothing on the outside going on, but yet they're hearing something. So for example, hearing voices when no one has spoken. Very easy way to remember hallucination is to think of your five senses. We learned our five senses in elementary school, so it shouldn't be that hard for you to remember, you know, the kinds of hallucinations, right? If you associate things, you're more likely to remember them. First sense, the most common, most frequently seen type of hallucination in schizophrenia is auditory. So that's hearing something that's not really going on. So hearing a ticking noise or hearing voices, though, that's auditory hallucinations. A lot of times you will see them on the unit doing this, holding their ears, rocking back and forth as a self-soothing mechanism, or they'll plug their ears or they'll put cotton in their ears. Because again, to them, these voices are very real. So they're trying to stop them. But what works better is competing with the noise. So for example, playing music or talking to someone, because we all know that these voices are really coming internally. It's not that they're real human voices, or it's just their brain kind of misfiring and creating the perception that there are voices. The next type of hallucination is visual. So with a visual hallucination, you see something that is not really there. So this guy right here, seeing an elephant walking across the bookshelf, that's an example of a visual hallucination. Next sense we have is the olfactory. So smelling something that's not really happening either. So for example, they'll say, I smell a rotting corpse, right? But there's no rotting corpse around. Nothing is rotting. Next is gustatory. So tasting something that, again, they say, I have blood in my mouth. I taste blood. And there's no blood there. There's no cuts. There's nothing whatsoever to indicate that there is blood or that they're tasting something that's bad. And then the last one is tactile. And tactile sensations, it says they will feel a lot of times like bugs are crawling all over their skin, and they'll scratch and they'll pick and they'll smash the bugs against the wall, and they'll just be like smack, smack, smack. Because again, they really see these animals crawling on the walls, on their skin. So they're at risk for a skin breakdown because they're picking at their skin so much. And a lot of times I see this when they're withdrawing from alcohol. So when they're detoxing from alcohol, and all of a sudden they get these tactile hallucinations. Now let's talk about what an illusion is. So an illusion is a mental impression derived from misinterpretation of an actual sensory stimulus. So for example, you think that you see someone and you get so scared and you're like, oh! But really it's a coat on a large coat hanger. Or magicians do a lot of illusion, right? When they're pulling a rabbit out of a hat, they're not really making a rabbit appear out of thin air. They're doing an illusion. So this is an example of an illusion. There's not, you know how in the previous slide there was a real, he thought he saw a real elephant walking? Well, this zebra looks like he's 3D. There's an actual zebra there that's drawn, but the artist made it appear as if the zebra is popping out of the page and as if the zebra is three-dimensional. So remember, an illusion is something that something is there, but we are interpreting it incorrectly. We are misinterpreting. Whereas with a hallucination, there is nothing there for us to misinterpret. It's completely coming from within the person. And remember, we have to be compassionate, because With hallucinations, to them, they are very real. So let's practice, okay? A client with schizophrenia states, "My heart has stopped and my blood is black ash." The nurse interprets this statement to be evidence of which of the following? Is it a hallucination? Is it an illusion? Is it a delusion? Or is it paranoia? Do, 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 do. Okay, so this was a bit of a trick question, but let's go through the thought process, right? Hallucination. Is this statement by the patient, is it related to the five senses? No, right? How about, are we misperceiving something? No. Does the patient say anything in regards to someone is chasing me, I'm being poisoned, or the FBI is coming to get me? No. So the correct answer was a delusion. A delusion is a false fixed belief. I think I will also do a video later on what delusions are because people get those confused with hallucinations as well. So let's review the rationale. Okay, rationale. The statement, "My heart has stopped and my blood is black ash," is a somatic delusion. A lot of times a somatic delusion will also be if these individuals think that their body is rotting from the inside in. It's a false fixed belief. A delusion is a false fixed belief. A hallucination is a false sensory perception. Remember your five senses, unrelated to external stimuli. And an illusion is a misinterpretation of a real sensory stimulus. And paranoia refers to suspicious of others and their actions. So the FBI is coming to get me. Please help me now. Or are you from the NSA? Who sent you? Someone's watching me. That's paranoia. I always like to end on with a funny meme. So this is classic nursing tests. Nursing students, well, that's correct. It's not the most correct. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you have now learned the difference between a hallucination and an illusion. Thank you, and make sure you hit the like and subscribe button. Bye.